If there's one unique thing about my stream, it's the fact that I don't need any headphones, ear monitors, or headset when I'm listening to my music. I can hear it naturally coming through speakers, but it doesn't feed back into my microphone during my live broadcast. And I get this question all the time. How do you do that without it ruining the audio that you're producing during your live stream? Well, if you're interested, I'm gonna share with you how I do it by using one simple tool that every brand new streamer should start using right now, because it's going to increase the clarity of your stream and eliminate so much of that background noise that is chasing away a lot of people coming into your stream. And I'm gonna show you right after this quick sponsor. Overlays, overlays, and overlays. That's right. If you need an awesome overlay, look no further than OWN. You want to kick up your stream's visual representation with some awesome eye candy? Take a look at the brand new Pixel Series package on OWN, where you can leap back into the pixel past and make your stream look oh so pretty. Take a look at owned.tv and always go down to the bottom of their website for awesome coupon codes so you can save money. Hey, want to save even more? Make sure you click through the links down in my video description to do just that. Now, back to the video. What is up, all you awesome people? Wild for Games here to make your content with live streaming bigger and better. Now, the tool I'm going to share with you is not only just good for if you want to hear music or sounds without the needs of like headsets and headphones, but it's also a great tool if you have background noise, like if you're near traffic or you have kids yelling in the background, or if it's hot where you live, you have your AC on, or yeah, even a fan in your room that's blowing towards your microphone. I'm going to show you how to solve all of that. So let's dive right into it. So here I am over on my OBS studio. How are you doing there? The first thing you want to do is make sure you go down to your microphone and click on the gearbox. And what you want to go to is filters. Now you want to add a noise gate. I've already got one added, but if you need to know, go down to the plus sign right here and click on noise gate. Real simple. When it loads up, it will have default settings, okay? When it comes to making adjustments to any microphone out there, there's gonna be variables. Remember, every microphone is different. There's different types of microphones, there's different sensitivities, different frequencies, different capsule sizes, and different polar patterns. Likewise, every room is gonna be its own unique environment. So the settings you see on this part right here will be not the same for you, but at least I can educate you on what every setting does so that way you can make the correct adjustment. All right. When you've added your filter to your audio settings, on the left side is where you'll see it active and inactive. When it has the eye mark, that means it's on. And when it's shaded out, that means it's turned off. The first two settings we want to be concerned with are close threshold and open threshold. Close threshold means whenever there's a sound below this number, it will not be picked up by your microphone. Hence, everything will be nice, quiet, and silent, so that way there's no background static or noise. On the opposite end, for open threshold, when any sound goes over this threshold number here, that's when the microphone will open and start receiving sound to your broadcast. Now, what you need to do is find the sweet spot for your particular microphone. There is no one setting, but surprisingly, when you first add the default settings, they work really well. But play around with this because your environment will really affect your microphone depending on how much sound dampening is in your room. Now, most people will say you want to keep the closed and open threshold between about 5 to 10 dB. You don't want to put them too wide and you don't want to put them too close together. You want to give it a nice range so that way it knows how to operate properly. Our next three settings really allow us to refine down how the noise gate is going to operate for when we talk and not talk. The first you're going to see is attack time. And this is the amount of time in milliseconds that the noise has to be active before the filter and microphone will be active to pick up sound. Generally, the shorter the number is better, but you don't want to make it too short. Otherwise, you can have things that will chop off or not be picked up. Hold time is how long the microphone will be active after you stop speaking. You wanna make sure you give enough ample time for it to fade out naturally. Again, so when you start talking or stop talking, it has a natural sound to it rather than just doing a straight cut. If you find that your audio gets chopped off with your words when they start or finish, it's generally due to hold time, so play around with this a little bit more. Release time is kinda like hold time. When you have a release time, it's how long till the filter will stop being active. Again, you want a nice natural fall off point to this. Again, don't have a shortcut. Now, when it comes to using noise gate, there is no one clear option. There's so many variables. I've seen people put their settings at 10, 10, and 10, or 25, 25, and 25, or leave them at the default. you need to play around with this. So what I recommend is when you start finding things in and how you see how the levels go on your microphone within the mixer, all you need to do is hit record and play around with it a little bit. So that way you really refine down the settings for you and your environment. Now, how does this all sound? Well, I'm gonna show you. Currently have my noise gate off and I own a whole house fan here. So I'm gonna turn this sucker on high really quick. Give it just about a few seconds to turn on. It's kicking on right now. And I'm gonna turn on this air fan right here and set it up so it blows right into the microphone. I'm gonna turn this sucker right on high. So now we should be able to have some background sound. So I'm gonna stop talking for a few seconds so that way you can hear the static. And if it's a little low, I'll bump it up in post so that way you guys can hear it. So hopefully you guys can hear that. Now I'm gonna turn on the noise gate audio filter. Nothing's being picked up on the microphone from background sound from the fan that's only 2.5 feet away blowing on full blast towards the microphone, nor my whole house fan, which is awesome because now you can eliminate all the background music. And this is how I do to listen to music that it's broadcasting through my speakers. I find a nice low setting that's not pushing towards my microphone so that way I can hear it, but it's just below that threshold point to where it won't activate my microphone. Also, remember, this filter is really great for traffic sounds, AC and fans blowing, louder PCs, people who smash on their keyboard, and general vibration sounds.
The best thing about a noise gate filter, it's the easiest to use, easiest to understand, and easiest for anyone to drop into their broadcasting software right now and start using right away. That's what I love about it. You can even amplify a noise gate filter by adding other filters. For example, like adding a suppression filter to it. So you really focus in on your audio so it's clear with minusing out all the background noise. Now, in no way is it the best audio filter. There's awesome things like the RTX audio filter out there. That's another video at another time. But you can use things like this. But if you're brand new to streaming and you have background noises that are bothering you, boom. This is an awesome way to do it. Or if you want to listen to music and not have it feedback into that microphone, again, another awesome way to do it. Now, there's a lot of awesome audio filters that are in broadcasting softwares and outside of broadcasting softwares that you can introduce. And if you want a video on some really cool filters or voice modulation programs for your stream or YouTube content creation or whatever you're doing, hey, do me a favor, leave me a comment down below and I'll see what I can do to help you out with that. If you need to make any microphone that you own right now sound velvety smooth, I've got a great video that I'm gonna put over here on the side for you that I really recommend that you check out because it's gonna teach you awesome ways to make your microphone literally 100 times better. I'll see you guys in the next video. Take care, stay safe, continue to be awesome, and as always, peace.